Hey guys, what's up? In this video, we're gonna add key movement or key listening. So I'm not even gonna really explain it too much. I'm just gonna jump right in. But the way I originally had planned it in my other game, it's not gonna really work because since you're playing on the same keyboard, it's gonna be a little bit off because you're not gonna be able to hold down each key. So I'm gonna take Longhorn Dude's method of doing it with using booleans and then using those for updating the player. And when it's like, say you have like a key pressed, it will set it to true, so like the player will move, and then on the release of that key, it will stop the player from moving. That way it will be able to use multiple keys at once for each player, so it won't feel like it won't cancel out a key after you push the second one down. And if you were to try it the other way with just pressing down keys and moving the player, you'd actually see what I'm talking about, but I'm not even going to do that. So just to save another video, I'm just going to go ahead and do it right the first time. So we're going to do implement key listener, and you get an error, so we'll import the event. And we're missing some methods, so implement those. And I'm just going to move them up to underneath our paint component. Delete this. Oops. And for this to work, we're going to need to add... In here, we'll add key listener this, and what that's gonna do is add a key listener to this program or the shooter. So the way we're gonna do this is key pressed is essentially you press a key down and it will work if you're holding it. Key typed, I'm not too sure what that is. I think it's just push down and release it really quick. Key release is if you're holding a key and then release it. We're not going to be using this method, but we do need it in here, so we'll just put that in there. It just means like it can be used, but you don't have anything in there. It's basically like closing the end of a line. So we'll create some things. I'm going to create them public just to save time, but you're going to want to go ahead and create these private with getters and setters for each one of these, and then use the getters for using them inside the player class. But I'm going to go ahead and do them public so it just saves me time to teach it, and I won't have to record too many more videos after this. So, public boolean. Player one left will do first, and by default these are going to be false. They're already false on startup, but right up down. Oh, we won't even need a right and left, actually. So the next really part that you're going to want to do is actually go ahead and add the code for it to make the these buttons actually change to true and false when you release the key. So the way you're going to do that is go to the key pressed, we'll do first, and do E dot get key code equals equals key event dot vk up and just copy this, put else if, and do vk down. So what this is gonna do is it's gonna, when you push this key, VK up, which is the arrow key up, it will move this player up And for this, we'll do just comment it for a second. Player 2 up. This one will be player 2 down. Okay. So I just pasted these into release. Player 2 up equals true. Player 2 down equals true. Just copy this. False. Player 2 down to false. So now when you actually push these keys, it will actually go ahead and change these things, but we're not doing anything with them yet. So the quickest way I think I'll do this is just give these things an ID, and we'll give this one 1 and 2. Now you notice you get an error. That's because in player we don't have it. So final in ID, but we're not going to be able to, I mean, this isn't the best method really, but it's going to work, I guess. And since we don't want it for anything else, like game object, then we don't need it for bullets. We don't need an ID for bullets, so we don't need it there. So, oops. Okay, and you can go ahead and create the getters and setters. I'm running out of time, or I'll just do that, whatever. Alright, and so what we're going to do is call player1.update, player2.update. And actually, instead of doing it that way, we'll just do it this way. Let's go ahead and remove this. I didn't even think of this before. As I said, I don't have a script. I'm just going on with this in my head, trying to figure out which way is best. So just remove these again. Sorry about this. This is just 570 there. Oh, I didn't remove it from here either. Alright, and now we need update to take on ID. But now if you notice, we're gonna have some issues. With that, but that's fine. Alright, so now we got all the things done, and we're just going to do, so if ID equals 1, that means it's player 1, else if ID equals 2, that means it's player 2, and this is where we'll actually go ahead and move the players, but we need to add stuff for player 1. So copy this, we're going to do VKW, copy it again, oops. So we'll actually go ahead and make the move in the next tutorial.